On the occasion of International World's Indigenous Peoples Day, I have decided to talk about its relevance, need, and importance. Let's jump straight into it. Who are these indigenous people? Indigenous people are those people who are living at that particular region as a First People, First Nation. They are the earliest inhabitants of that region, even different from those people who have occupied or settled at that region. They live in all the regions of the world and occupy 22% of the global land area. If we talk about India, indigenous people comprise an estimated population of 104 million or 8.6% of the national population. Although there are 705 officially recognized ethnic groups, there are many more ethnic groups which are not officially recognized. Means that the total number of tribal groups is undoubtedly higher than the official figure. So what made UN to mark the date as an International World's Indigenous Peoples Day? On 23rd December 1994, the United Nations General Assembly has decided that 9th of August shall be observed as an International World's Indigenous Peoples Day. There are many reasons behind to mark this date as an International World's Indigenous Peoples Day, and they are to protect the interest and rights of these indigenous people so that they couldn't lose their identity, to cope up with the challenges that these people are facing, such as marginalization, extreme poverty and human violation, to pay tribute to these people and their sacrifices, to acknowledge their significant role in sustaining the diversity of the world's culture and biological landscape. Now the question is, how this day has been celebrated around the world? Every year, UNESCO celebrates this day by sharing the activities that are related and important to the annual theme. People around the nation also celebrate this day by spreading awareness, considering the sacrifices of these people. But in India, they are rarely celebrated. We want to see tribal handicrafts at Delhi Haats and local fairs, but we don't wish to acknowledge their existence and their rights to live in. This is the harsh reality. I have one question for you. What if you have to survive your life with hurdles and you couldn't find a way to get rid of? This is how these people are struggling with. The major struggle is to live at their homeland. Let's have an example. A roadless valley in the foothills of the Kaimur Range in the Indian state of Uttar Pradesh is part of a range that is home to marginalized indigenous Adivasis, displaced from a nearly village century. The Adivasi in Uttar Pradesh, like some of the 100 million other indigenous people in India, carry gene markers dating from the first stone age of colonization of Asia. Even if we see globally, then more than 86% of indigenous people globally work in the informal economy, as compared to 66% for their non-indigenous counterparts. Indigenous peoples are nearly three times as likely to be living in extreme poverty compared to their non-indigenous counterparts. Globally, 47% of all indigenous peoples in employment have no education, compared to 17% of their non-indigenous counterparts. This gap is even wider for women. These are the most commonly found information of indigenous people of India on the internet. As much as we must know about their hardships and struggles, we must also know about their lifestyle, culture, and much more. So we at Jano Junction would love to invite stories from our original inhabitants and urge them to share about themselves and their life and their culture. If you have something to share or know people who should share about the things that people should know more about, then mail us on janojunction@gmail.com. Let's preserve the beauty of diversity that India is known for. This is Aru Sapra and I'm looking for your participation. Thank you.